Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm showing you four different frame hold or video freeze frame effects inside of Premiere Pro. Now, a freeze frame enables you to extend one frame for any duration of time and create some cool freeze frame snapshot effects. So I'll be showing you a bunch of different tricks and methods for creating freeze frames in Premiere Pro. So if you want to skip ahead to a particular effect, I put all the time codes below, so you can just click on that to skip ahead to check out one of those effects. And all of the assets that I'm using in this tutorial are linked below as well. So if you want to follow along, you can check those out. But without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on in. Here in my timeline, I have this motocross shot of this guy jumping on his bike. It looks pretty cool. And let's say you wanted to add a freeze frame at this moment right here. The first way to do this is to just simply control click or right click on the clip and select add frame hold. What this will do is it'll create a cut at the playhead, and then the rest of the shot is frozen in time. So it plays and then it's frozen. And this is great and all, but let's say you just wanted it to be frozen for a second or so, and then you want the video to continue. Now, this method will not work. This is where we have to insert a frame hold segment instead. So let's go ahead and hit Command Z to undo that. And let's go back to the moment that we want it to be frozen. Let's say right here, and let's go ahead and control click again, and let's insert frame hold segment. What this will do is it'll split the clip and it will insert a frame hold segment that's 2 seconds in between. So the video is going, it's frozen for 2 seconds, and then it continues. To adjust the duration of this segment, you can hover at the end of this segment here and see how it's a red trim icon. If you hit Command on a Mac, it'll turn yellow. Hold that down till it turns yellow, then click and drag, and you can drag this out to make it as long as you want. And then you can see how it ripples over the end of the video automatically. If you want to make it shorter, just press it again and then roll it back in, and then it ripple deletes in. So inserting a frame hold segment between your clip here is the fastest way to create a freeze frame. But just doing that doesn't add much value to your edit. You actually need to think about what sort of effect you're going to create. So next I'm going to show you how to create a snapshot freeze frame effect using some sound effects and some built-in transitions. So at this moment, let's say we want it to go black like a shutter effect. This is where I can go to effects and search for the dip to black transition. So you can see it's located under the video transitions folder underneath dissolve. So at this moment, I'm going to drag and drop this effect between these two clips at the cut point. And then I can select the transition and grab the end of it to make it shorter or longer. I'm gonna make it shorter, but of course you can always select it and then go up to effect controls. And if you want to make it a specific duration, you can type it in. I wanna make it exactly 5 frames. So now that is done. If we play it back, you can see it just flashes and then it goes on. So to really sell this, we need to add some sound effects. So at this moment, I'm going to zoom in a little bit so it's easier to see. And I'm going to add a camera shutter effect that I downloaded from Envato Elements. So I have this right here, camera 01. I'm going to drag and drop this to line up exactly with the transition. So I'm going to make this layer a little bit bigger, and I'm going to hold Option and use the arrow bracket keys to just move this over 1 frame. So I can use these arrow keys just to nudge it over while holding the Option or the Alt key if you're on a PC. And then I have a lens shut camera effect, and I'm going to drag and drop this right where this sound clip ends. So I'll bring this up to video layer 1 and this one up to video layer 2, and I'll nudge this over by holding Option. And now if we play this back, you'll see what it looks like. So I still think that this freeze frame is a little long. I want to shorten the duration, so I'm going to hit Command again, and I'm going to roll this in, and you can see the duration in that gray overlay. I'm going to make it around 18 frames. And now let's see how this looks. And then it continues on. So that's a basic camera freeze frame effect. But if you want it to be a little bit more complicated or interesting, you can download some camera overlays from Envato Elements. They have a bunch of different pre-made animations with sound effects. So if I play this back, I was able to create a little camera overlay with a sound effect there. Of course, you don't need to use the Envato Elements overlay. You can definitely make your own overlay in Photoshop. It just takes a little bit longer. So I encourage you guys to go explore the different camera overlays that are available in Envato Elements. I use them all the time. So next, if you're dealing with multiple layers in your timeline, which is probably going to happen more often than not, it's actually better to use a custom frame hold instead of doing the insert frame hold segment. So I'm going to show you how to do that now in the timeline. So here I have multiple layers. I have this animated subscribe button that animates in and out, and this couple jumping up and down. Now what I want to do is make this animated text lasts the entire duration of this video clip. But this is a motion graphics template. I can't extend this out. If I click on it and go up to the Essential Graphics panel, I have some parameters to change here, but there isn't a parameter to change the duration, just basics like customizing the color and the text. So what we need to do is use a frame hold to achieve this duration change. So if we move the playhead to the moment that we want to create a freeze frame and we control click or right click and hit insert frame hold segment, this will actually create a split on all of the layers, which can get complicated if you have an audio clip. Like here, I have this music track. So I'm going to hit Command Z to undo that. And what we want to do instead is do a custom frame hold. So this is where I'm going to zoom in a little bit and I'm going to create a cut here. I'm going to hit C on my keyboard and cut, and then I'm going to use the arrow keys to go one frame over and make another cut. And here is where I'm going to go back to the selection tool or hold V on your keyboard and select this frame. And on this frame, I'm going to control click and add frame hold. And then we need to control click again and go to frame hold options. And this is where we're going to change it to sequence time code, because this will allow us to change the duration to match any duration in our sequence. So hit OK. Just like before, I'm going to hover over this end of this frame, hit Command, so it's yellow, and then drag it out to extend it. And I'm going to zoom out a little bit so it's easier here, and then hit Command and pull this over. So this is super useful. I use this on all of my motion graphics templates, so that way it can exactly match the duration I want it to be. The last way to make a freeze frame from your video is using the export frame method. Now this involves a few more steps and takes a little bit more time, which is why it's not my favorite method, but I usually use this method if I'm going to export a frame for a thumbnail that I'm creating for my video or a design that I'm creating in Photoshop. So let me show you how it works. So what you can do is just kind of go through until you find the moment where you want to make your freeze frame. And rather than right clicking on the clip, you're going to go up to this menu bar and you'll find an icon that says export frame. It looks like a little camera. If you do not see this here, just go to the button editor and then drag this button into the toolbar. So just simply click on this icon and it will bring up a new window. Here in this new window, you can change the name and you can choose a different format to export it as. I'll just export it as a PNG file. And also because you're exporting this, it's going to be saved somewhere on your computer. So if you don't want it to be in your downloads folder, you can browse and you can export it to a specific folder dedicated to these exported frames. And if you want it to be imported into the project, you need to make sure that this is checked. So then hit OK. And now I can double click on this file in the project panel and you'll see that it's just this frame. And then if you want to bring it into your timeline, you can just drag and drop it. And then we can make a cut right here where the freeze frame begins and then just drag this clip over, bring this one down. And now we have the video frozen at this moment, and then it continues on just like we did before. But this method is a little bit more clunky, a little bit more steps, it takes a little bit longer, and that's why I mainly use this method for exporting my thumbnails. So I hope these methods are useful to you for creating frame holds in your own video. And before we wrap up, I want to tell you guys about this new RGB F7 fold light that Falcon Eyes sent to me. Now, this light is really cool. It's foldable. It's a pocket light. You can travel with it. It is a little bit heavier than some of the other lighter on-camera lights that I have, but that's just because it has so much power inside of it, and it's rechargeable via USB-C cables. Of course, you can turn it into any color that you want, and you can also change it to just a white, bluer light or a more tungsten color if you're just lighting a normal scene. And right behind me right now, I have the Falcon Eyes F7 original panel that they sent me. It's just one panel, and I use it just to add more color to my set here, just to make it more interesting. Without it, it just doesn't have as much of a pop. There's also lots of creative effects that you can use with this light. So you can download the app Diesel Light, and you can control it from your phone, and you can get really cool effects like fire truck or police, paparazzi, strobe effects, party effects, candle, TV, all sorts of different cool effects that will help you build some creative sets while you're filming. So Falcon Eyes did not sponsor this video, but they sent me the light to test out, and I liked it so much, I thought that you guys would enjoy it as well. And I put my Amazon affiliate link in the description box below if you're interested in checking it out. And lastly, to wrap up this video, I'd like to share with you my favorite comment of the week from Dr. Paul Lilly. He wrote, "Thank you so much. I can't begin to tell you how helpful this is for me. I've been looking for ways to make finance more interesting with green screen and masking. This is incredible." With a heart. So thank you, Dr. Paul, for that comment on the 6 creative masking effects. I'm so glad that it helped you out to get started in video and make finance a little bit more interesting. So yeah, that's all for this video. Don't forget to give it a big thumbs up if you liked it, and also leave a comment below. And yeah, stay creative, and remember, practice makes perfect. See you guys next time. Bye.
You know that I'ma keep it cool. With you I feel like breaking rules. On the edge looking out with no parachute. You know I'm dreaming about